Hey, what's going on? If you want to learn how to make creative restaurant quality food, then you've landed in the right place. I feel like we've all had that experience where we go out to a restaurant and we have something and we're just like, God dang, that is so good. I need to make that again myself. You know, you might feel like, oh, I'm a good cook, or I know how to do this in the kitchen, but this is beyond me. And I'm here to tell you that it's not. That restaurant food is actually a lot more approachable than you might realize. So right about meow, you're probably wondering a couple things. One, who the heck are you? And two, is that a Baby Yoda shirt you're wearing underneath your apron? And to answer these questions in order of importance, yes, this is a Baby Yoda shirt. And in fact, what you can't see is that it says, "What would Baby Yoda do?" which I personally think is a fantastic life philosophy. And as for who I am, I went to culinary school and then I cooked in a bunch of high-end restaurants for a number of years. Now, I've since changed careers, but even during my time in restaurants, and since then, I would run a speakeasy style restaurant where I would put a menu online, I would sell tickets, and then for one night at a time, I would open up a restaurant in a secret location where I could really serve the food that spoke to me, focusing not so much on what it takes to run a profitable business, but what I and my friends really enjoy in hospitality, bringing that to other people. So meow, I wanna share that with you. Show you how to make the kind of food that I would create for the restaurants I worked in or for the speakeasy style pop-ups I would do. All my food is going to be broken up into two distinct phases. It's going to be broken up into prep and then steps to fire or finish the dish. The reason for this is the exact same way that we would prepare food in either the restaurant or I do for my secret meals. And what that does is it allows you to front load a lot of the work. For one, just for your home meals, it's gonna make your life way easier because we don't always have just massive amounts of time to sit there and make a meal from start to finish, right? We're all super busy. So when you have a pocket of time, maybe an hour here or an hour there, maybe you can prep out some stuff, set it in the fridge and have that done. And after that's done, then when it's time to eat, you'll understand just very minimal steps you need to do to finish off your food, allowing you to have a better meal. You can make any of my recipes from start to finish, super doable. So the other thing that this is going to allow you to do is easily build multi-course meals. Because each of my videos is going to be broken down into prep and then firing steps, what you can always do is work through the prep steps of multiple videos, store everything, then when it comes time to eat, all you have to do is go through the fire steps of one dish, eat that or serve it, and then you can go through the fire steps of the second dish. That will just make your life so much easier so you can have these big meals and not sit back in the kitchen pinned away from everybody else. This kind of food and these kinds of meals should be accessible to everybody. And yes, I have my recipes, but hopefully over time, what you'll be able to do is take the concepts that I'm teaching and apply that to your own food. And if you're watching this and you're like, yeah, that sounds cool, but I'm scared. Don't be scared. Good food does not have to be complicated. And while yes, some of what I will make will be sophisticated, a lot of it will be very simple, but even the more complicated dishes, I will break down into very simple steps to follow. If you ever have a question, please let me know. I will always do my best to answer whatever you need to know. Enough blabbing. Let's get started with some food.